What do you need to do? Do you need to write something? 10 seconds is all he needs for you to stay. I'm going to sit at my desk. The next 10 seconds, he needs you to open that word processor. The next 10 seconds, he needs you to write that sentence. It's not overwhelming, it's very simple, and this is the truth of life. Because all you have is now. And therefore, you cannot solve your problems. You cannot deal with the healing that you need to deal with from the past. You cannot bring your goals and achieve your goals in the world unless you understand that. That God just needs the next 10 seconds, and the next 10 seconds, and the next 10 seconds. And as soon as you realize God only needs those 10 seconds, you will begin to change your life, the life of people around you, and the world around you as well. God only needs the next 10 seconds of your life. It's a simplistic, factual truth when it comes to building on behalf of the unconditioned love of God that many of us are absent from realizing. And I have said this twice this week to two different people, and I thought, let me make a short video about this. What do I mean God only needs the next 10 seconds of your life? Well, many of us are seeking to have peace in our hearts, healing perhaps. Others are seeking the destiny that God's voice has for them in this world. And yet we are unable to manifest it in our lives because we get lost and we lose track of the fact that God only needs the next 10 seconds. If you take a list of all of the things in the world that you are worried and concerned about, make a nice list of it. Now take all of those things in there that you can have zero impact on today. Take them and put them to one side. I don't mean that you feel you might have an impact by posting your opinion on social media, but have a genuine direct impact upon. If you cannot have a genuine direct impact upon the direction of stories in the mainstream media, etc., etc., or on the lives of those around you through this problem you are facing, put it to one side. Then take a look at what is left in your list. What are you able to have an impact upon is what should be there. But now you may have boundaries and walls that you are unable to conquer because they are getting in the way of you moving towards these things upon your list. And so write down the boundaries that you have. Maybe it's your health. Maybe it's you lack discipline. Maybe it's that you get anxious. Maybe it's that you are just overwhelmed and disorganized. Look at these things. Look at them together with me. Here you have a list of problems that you can now actually affect, and now you have another list of problems that are coming from within you that mean you cannot move towards them. You cannot make headway upon them. When you see that, take a good strong look at what I say next. God only needs the next 10 seconds. Maybe God has called you and asked you, I need you to do this in the world. And you feel you can't because you have this problem, this anxiety, this concern, doubt. And therefore you're moving by sight and not faith. Anything that your brain tells you to stop you from moving towards the goals you have for your life or to solve the issues you face in your life. This is sight, not faith. And so for just this moment, let's pretend and imagine that we're going to do it by faith. And so here is your goal. Here is your problem. All the reasons you can't solve them. Sight. Bury the sight. Let's move to faith. Here is your goal. What is the first step towards going towards your goal? By faith, that step might be, I need to write something. I need to build something. I need to open something. I need to open my website. I need to call this person and get some advice. Your duty now to serve your highest good is to give God the next 10 seconds. And by faith, eliminate all of that chatter, doubt, and worry. All of that inner character and its emotions. Find a stable stillness in the midst of all of that that goes on inside the brain. And then merely take a step towards the goal of solving the problem or bringing whatever it may be into the world. The next 10 seconds. It's all God needs. It's all God needs. And you will find that if you can understand that, if you can witness that, you will see that there is no need for you to try to do anything in those 10 seconds once you reach there. Once you reach the true point of walking by faith, and you've realized all these worries and anxieties that you can't address, it's totally illogical to worry about them because there's nothing you can do. And you realize that that which you can do, you are unable to do because your brain and your mind ultimately is full of thoughts to the contrary of the action you need to take and doubts. And so you just feel paralyzed. And so you head off and just go back to the habit of entertainment to distract you from that discomfort. And you enter that space finally of saying, okay, all I have is one task and it's 10 seconds long. You will find there's not much you need to do. Because organically, spontaneously, through your energy of your body, God, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of all, the white light of creation, will talk to you in that space. For silence, as Rumi said, is the language of God and all else is poor interpretation. Next 10 seconds, all God needs. What do you need to do? Do you need to write something? 10 seconds is all he needs for you to stay. I'm going to sit at my desk. The next 10 seconds, he needs you to open that word processor. The next 10 seconds, he needs you to write that sentence. It's not overwhelming, it's very simple, and this is the truth of life. Because all you have is now. And therefore, you cannot solve your problems. You cannot deal with the healing that you need to deal with from the past. You cannot bring your goals and achieve your goals in the world unless you understand that God just needs the next 10 seconds and the next 10 seconds and the next 10 seconds. And as soon as you realize God only needs those 10 seconds, you will begin to change your life, the life of people around you, and the world around you as well. Next 10 seconds. It's all God needs for you to achieve your goals, your dreams, and what he, she has in store for you. God bless, guys. Take care. Bye.